Jessica here, your furry family coach. So many people have been asking me questions lately about their new puppies. So in this video, we're going to talk about the 5 biggest mistakes to avoid when you get a new puppy. And stick around till the end because I'm going to give you a bonus tip that just may save you from pulling all your hair out. Seriously, you don't want to miss it. Jessica here, and like I said, so many people have been asking questions lately about their new puppies. So I thought I'd put together this list of the 5 biggest mistakes to avoid when getting a new puppy. Mistake number 1, if you have kids, and so many pet parents do, you really need to practice safe pet handling with your kids. Don't expect your children to just know how to handle and play with a dog, or a cat for that matter. Take the time and show your kids how to be gentle, how to play appropriately, and teach them patience, and how to watch for body language cues in your dog. And never, ever leave young children alone with a dog. Mistake number 2, as exciting as it is for you, adopting a new dog or puppy is stressful to the dog. Give them some space at first and be supportive. Provide love and praise and show them that their new home is a safe place for them. Mistake number 3, do your best to adopt a new puppy when you have some time off from work. A new puppy needs lots of guidance, love, and attention. Taking 2 weeks off would be best, but do the best you can and take off at least a few days and acclimate your new dog to their new home. You can't bring home a new puppy one night and expect them to be perfectly adjusted by morning. Mistake number 4, your new dog or puppy needs to be exposed to new situations and experiences to be well adjusted. I like to use the 100 things in 100 days technique. Find a new experience every day, nothing crazy or too far out of the comfort zone, but regular activities that will push your dog to become a social butterfly. For instance, you can take a trip to the vet's office once a week and just have the staff love on your dog and give them a treat. This way, when you have to go in for an appointment, they won't be so scared. And mistake number 5, house training is serious business, and your dog is not born with the knowledge that peeing inside is bad. Begin your potty schedule from day 1. Puppies need lots of practice and lots of guidance. When they get it right, throw them a party. Give love and praise and, of course, those wonderful treats. All right, guys, so those are the 5 biggest mistakes I'm seeing most people make when getting a new dog or puppy. But don't forget about that bonus tip I told you about. This one really will save you tons of anxiety and maybe even keep you from pulling out your hair. What is this wonderful tip, you ask? It's enrichment. Yes, start right away. Provide lots of enrichment for your dog. This will help keep your dog entertained and using their energy in a good way and away from all those things you don't want them to get into, like chewing shoes or digging through the trash, tearing up your carpet, and so forth. Enrichment can be so many different things. Build a sandbox in the backyard for those diggers. Use treat toys for interactive playtime. Make a snuffle mat. Go on long walks and let your dog smell all the smells. There are so many ideas out there, so be creative. All right, so that'll do it for this video. I hope this helped you with your puppy, and if you know someone who could use the advice, share this video with them. If you haven't already, join the Train Positive group. I'll put a link in the description. Give this video a big thumbs up. And don't forget to hit that subscribe button before we go. I'll see you in the next video.